as prominent in recent years by dispatching bigger and bigger ships with smaller and smaller crews. Was this a disaster waiting to happen?
Well, in many ways, this event was brought on by the last closure of the Suez Canal. The Suez Canal closed during 1968, and the eight-year closure for it, the maritime industry had a route around Africa, and they started developing these larger vessels, the economy of scale. Let's put more cargo on a single vessel instead of across several vessels. The Suez Canal was expanded in 2015 specifically to handle a vessel like the Ever Given. And again, our economy, we demand, you know, low-cost transportation, and the way to afford that is by creating these larger and larger vessels. And the question is, was this passage of the Ever Given through the canal prudent at the time? If they had concerns about high winds, as the company is saying, then the pilots on board should have been aware of that. They should have taken the vessel into the canal. The vessel was only about
questions. Let's see here, from the satellite, Martin. Shows on the satellite that the ship and the large ship is at an angle, pretty much locking at an angle for the entrance point right into the Suez Canal. Snapshots were given a good look at how a 400-meter-long ship is completely blocking traffic in one of the world's most important maritime trade routes, which connects Mediterranean with the Red Sea. The vessel operated by Taiwanese shipping company ran aground on Tuesday, forcing more than 320 ships to wait for their turn to sail through the canal. Niggers were dispatched to
Second Ezra 6. Second Ezra 6 and 22, and suddenly shall the sown places appear unsown. The full storehouses shall suddenly be found empty. So relating to supplies, the storehouses, you know, maybe for example of this, they could start to be empty again, relating to these stores, relating to the supplies, relating to the Suez, this cargo ship, because it transports supplies worldwide to various countries all over the world, including here. One of the list of major countries here in the United States, you know, all the different types of supplies. So it can affect pretty much the supplies, man, that in these stores, man. For example, toilet paper and different other supplies, man. So the storehouses, suddenly be found empty. So things could start becoming empty again. You know, I mean, we on a precursor of different things happening anyway, relating to supplies, a high demand, limited supply. So we'll go to Ecclesiastes 6 and 14. 15, 5 and 15. Ecclesiasticus or Sirach 5 and 15, be not ignorant of anything in a great matter or a small. So this is a major great matter, man. Important matter. You know what I mean? So be not ignorant relating to the impact, relating to the supplies that can affect, man. You know, because it affects directly, indirectly, relating to getting certain things specifically here in this country and worldwide, all over, hundreds of millions of dollars a day. You know, it's a backlog with this ship being blocked. It's blocking other ships to get to and fro, whatever supplies they have. And it's a global, international thing. So be not ignorant of, I'm going to read that again, be not ignorant of anything in a great matter or small. So be not ignorant, whether great or small. This is something sure relating information on the Suez Canal, of that ship, the ever given. Give all praise to Al Bashim, Yashal Bashim, Rakakada, Shalom.